say my real name's Rita. Everyone still calls me Rita. The funny thing is that Steve worked with me and knew me as a mate for 12 years, and he called me Cheryl in all that time. And then when we started going out together, he said, I'm not going to call you Cheryl anymore, I'm going to call you Rita, and that was that. I became a professional singer in 1975. That was the first band I ever joined. It was called Mother's Pride. And the guy who was in that band had a girlfriend, not a girlfriend, but a girlfriend who had a boyfriend. And that was Steve Stroud. And I became really good friends with her. She was lovely. She introduced me to Steve, and he was really friendly, and he bought us a drink, and that was that. And I went to see his band again a few times. Our paths used to cross all the time then, even more so, you know. And we'd be in a venue in Manchester, and they'd be in the venue at the end of the road, because there were an awful lot of live gigs in the 70s. And so on our night off, we'd go and see Sparrow, and Sparrow would come and see Coco, and I'd see it, and he'd talk to me, and he'd talk to me about Jenny and how she's not the right girl for him. And me, you know, I never ever thought, oh, he's trying to pull me, because I was so green, so naive. And I used to say to him, no, you need to persevere, because she's such a lovely girl. 12 years after first meeting Steve in 1975, I suddenly saw this beautiful, fabulous, lovely man. And I just looked at him and thought, why haven't I seen anything in Steve before? He's lovely. I've had all these other relationships. I've been engaged a few times, and Steve was always there with a shoulder for me to cry on when something went wrong. And in 1987, I rang him and I said, Steve, I need to talk to you. There's something on my mind, you know, and it involves you. And he went, all right, Cheryl, don't worry. And he came straight round, and we went out for a meal. And I said, I like you more than I ought to, because we're mates. And he went, no, you can't, you know, if it all goes wrong, if it all goes pear-shaped, then we lose our friendship as well as a possible relationship. But I wouldn't take no for an answer. Our first date was October the 17th, and Steve asked me to marry him 3 Christmases later, so it was 2 years and a few months later, Christmas Day. And his family were coming over. There would be 11 of us sitting down to dinner. And then we'd opened all the presents, and he said, oh, there's one more in the tree. And it was a little box. And I thought, oh, is it what I think it is? And I was praying that it was. I really was. I'd been engaged 3 times before. But I think the 3 times before had only been because, well, I suppose it felt right at the time. But I never, ever felt I'm going to marry this person. Whereas with Steve, I wanted him to be my husband. I really wanted him to be my lifetime partner, you know. And so I opened this box, and it was an engagement ring, and I was just made up, made my life. He didn't go on his hands and knees. Well, he wouldn't go on his hands and knees. He'd just go on his knee, wouldn't he? One knee. His hands and knees, that's a different game altogether. We got married on Blackheath in South London. There's a beautiful church there called All Saints, and it's like a chocolate box. It's just perfectly built, and it's got a lovely spire, and I really wanted to get married there. We had our wedding there, and then we had our wedding reception at Blackheath Concert Halls, which again, inside, was a fabulous venue, and it needed to be able to take about 500 people, which it did comfortably. I'm not a very starry person. My friends in show business are friends. They're not friends because they're showbiz, it's just coincidental. Peter Howitt, who was the original Joey in Bread, who's now a fabulous director. Mike Nolan, Shelley Preston, and Bobby G was there from Bucks Fizz. And that was it. This is the cape. Oh, it smells of clothes that haven't been out for years. It's ever so heavy. I think I took this off. Did I take it off? I can't remember. Working with Steve for all those years, he was Jack the Lad, and I used to watch him, and he'd be like a different girl in every venue that we played on tour, and I used to think, oh, poor girl who ends up with Steve Stroud. And it was me.